Hello. So today I thought we could look at what is the most common noun in the English language and possibly other languages, which is time. Apparently, we say time more often than any other noun, which is interesting. And it also makes it quite hard to talk about time because you just keep saying time all the time. It gets confusing. But what we So obviously, time is really important to music and other kinds of patterns. And today we're going to be thinking about, well, we'll look at how we set the tempo in terms of cycles per second. Interestingly, how we can pattern that. We can pattern the number of cycles per second. And we'll also start looking at a couple of functions. So up to now, we've mainly been focused on the MIDI notation. But now is the time to drop in a couple of functions, in particular fast and slow. So this is happening within what is ostensibly effect week, but I thought it'd be nice to start looking also at time, also as time as an effect, which is confusing. Okay, let's have a look. I've just typed in a little rhythm using the CPU sample bank. Thanks again to CPU Records for contributing this fine sample bank. So by default, so this rhythm is happening once per cycle. And by default, the number of cycles per second is 0.5625, I think, which is 135 divided by 60 divided by 4. Yes. So that is significant because 135 is the tempo for pretty fast techno. It used to be that the default number of cycles per second was one, I think, or maybe 0.5. And so, because this is talking in terms of second, normally we give tempos in terms of beats per minute. And that's why I put 135 here. So 0.5625 is the equivalent of 135 beats per minute. But if you divide that by 60 to get beats per second, and then divide by 4, which assumes that there's 4 beats per cycle, then you get 0.5625, which is the cycles per second. So that's just to convert between the standard way of giving tempo in beats and cycles I temp Tidal's idea of cycles per second. Okay, that was a bit of a distraction. So, but we can change that with setcps. So if I keep that running and increase that a bit to 0.7. So yeah, it changes the quality of the rhythm a lot depending on how fast it goes. So that's how you can do that. So that just changes the cycles per second. So cycles per second is global. So if I put another thing here, like then have this going on top. Then if I change this, it would change it for both. They're perfectly in sync, and the CPS is the kind of global tempo. So there you go. Now the interesting thing is that you can. We've been looking at effects like squiz, for example. So on this pattern, I've just made a it squiz effect set to 5. But you can also do this with CPS. So instead of doing set CPS, we can actually put this here. So if I put CPS 0.7, now whenever an event gets sent, the CPS is also set at the same time. And again, this is global. Even though I'm pinning it on one pattern, it's affecting everything. So it doesn't make sense to put CPS on more than one pattern, really. And we can pattern this. So if I put one, then two. That's pretty weird because we've got the first half will be running at a CPS of one, and the second half will be running at a CPS of two. So it suddenly turns it into a kind of waltz. It's like three time because the first half, this goes twice as fast, so it's like half the length of this. So you end up with a kind of three beat pattern. Let's just try that a bit slower. Whereas if I change it back, so you can have a lot of fun with this, making what was quite a regular beat into something quite different. You could even try it with like a continuous thing. So now I've got a sawtooth wave, which goes from 0 to 1 smoothly over a cycle. I'm adding 0.5 to it, so it actually goes from 0.5 to 1.5 then. And then whenever an event is sent, it'll sample a value from that saw wave. So over the cycle, it's now speeding up. And again, it's affecting everything. So you can make, if you want to make some really mind-bending music, then start using tempo as an effect. So another way of changing how fast a pattern is going is with fast and or slow. So let's just take this. Let's set the CPS back to 0.6 for now and listen to this. So we put fast and then how fast we want it to go in front. Now, if I just do that, this won't work. It'll come up with a horrible error. What I need to put here is a dollar. This is because what fast wants from us is how fast we want it to go and then the pattern. But Tidal won't know that you're not just passing it this n, which doesn't make sense. Like this, you can't have n without a pattern. So what the dollar does is it's really low precedence or really low priority, which means that everything else gets worked out first. So what this is basically saying is work out everything to the right, turn that to into a pattern before passing it into fast two. This takes a while to get your head around. And it might be best just to put it in with and play with the example without trying to understand it too much. Get a feel for what it's doing before really getting to grips to what's going on. So that works. So now it's just going twice as fast. Another way, by the way, of thinking about this is putting the whole thing in parenthesis, as this will also work. Because this is saying, work out all of this, and then once you've done that, pass it to fast two. This is just a bit easier, especially when you get lots of functions going on, because you don't have to match the left and right brackets. So dollar is generally the easiest thing to use. So what I can do is put 0.5 here, a half, which will make it go slower. So if you go fast by a factor of 0.5, it'll go slower. But then maybe it makes more sense to use the slow instead and put 2. So these actually mean the same thing. You can say go half as fast or twice as slow. The end result is exactly the same. And conversely, if I want to go half as slow, that's actually twice as fast. You can also say go 2/3 as fast. Again, you have to put it in brackets Otherwise, Tidal will think you mean slow to, and then it'll get to this and won't know what this divide 3 is relating to. So if you want it to go 2/3, then you have to put it in brackets, so to make sure it's a parameter to this. In this case, the dollar won't work because it'll try and work out all of this to pass it to this as a single kind of parameter. Again, just maybe it's easiest just to work with the examples that I give you and not worry too much about the syntax. You can change the numbers and add things without having to understand the whole thing. Right, so that's fast and slow. The only other thing to say about this is this number is itself a pattern. So what you can do is use mini notation or something like that. So we can say make the first half 0.5 and the second half 2. So the first half would be slow and the second half would be fast. Okay, I'm just trying to work out for myself what is going on here. So this is playing for the first half of the pattern, it's playing half speed, and for the second half, it's playing at twice the speed. So if you imagine it's kind of switching between two different versions, one is playing half speed, and one is playing twice the speed. So the half speed version, you're kind of cutting into when it's playing this. So the first time around it would be playing this at half speed. But you only hear this because you're only getting half the cycle. The second time around it's running at half speed, so it'll be getting as far as this. But because you're only getting half the cycle, you only hear this. So that means that you're getting something like this and then this for the first half. This is the end pattern. For the second half, you're going at twice the speed, so you get this twice every cycle, but then you're only getting the second half of the cycle. And so you just get it once. So this is actually just the same as this. So if I play that, these should now both sound the same. Yeah. So this is a bit confusing. This isn't kind of taking this pattern and then sort of running it through and then speeding up. What it's actually doing is switching between two different versions of the pattern, one which is half the speed, one which is twice the speed. This is not something that's easy to get your head around either, but it's one of those things where it doesn't really matter too much whether you know exactly what's going on or not, because all you want is to have a fast bit and a slow bit, and you can just ask for that and just let Tidal work out how to do that for you. But later on, I'll show some diagrams and things which will make this clearer. I promised some diagrams in the last video as well, and I'll get all that together for you soon. Okay, so to summarize, there's setcps just for setting the global CPS. You can also use CPS on its own as an effect in one of the patterns to really mess with time. And you can also use fast and slow, either simply if you want it to go twice as fast, half the speed, or if you want to get into weird time travel, you can pattern that as well. So yeah, hopefully that's useful. Feel free to ask questions about anything that's confusing. I really don't mind. In fact, I really enjoy answering questions. I often learn a lot through the process of answering them. See you soon on the forums or whatever. Bye.